on any kind of a charge. I want to get on to the business that we came here to do today. Jane Fonda ran down the fact that we really, really need money. And I really hope that you will give everything you can, keeping in mind that you are defending yourselves. You're defending yourselves, you're defending the struggle, you're defending the cause of liberation. So while the brothers and sisters are circulating in the crowd, I'd like to run down the demands that we, the Soledad Brothers Defense Committee, have formulated, which we think will be able to begin to deal effectively with what's happening in the prison. Now, we want to go over and let the adult authority and the Department of Corrections know that we are moving on this, that we will not stop until there are no more prisons except for those people that I was talking about before, except for the real criminals. So we will not stop until all political prisoners are free.
On the 7th day of August of the year 1970, a 17-year-old man-child walked into the silent courtroom of Marin County. Tall, evil, graceful, bright-eyed, black man-child. Courage in one hand, assault rifle in the other. He died on the trigger, scourge of the unrighteous. Soldier of the people. Terrible man-child. All right, gentlemen, said Jonathan Peter Jackson, cold and calm. I'm taking over now.